Hi, and welcome to Video Toolkit Essentials for Streaming Corporate Communications. I'm Alden Fertig, VP of Product here at Ustream.
I'm Rob Reed, Business Development Manager for Roland Professional AV.
And Rob and I and Roland and Ustream decided to get together and do this joint presentation because we found something was happening, a synergy between our two companies and our two products. And we called it Video Toolkit Essentials for Streaming Corporate Communications because what we found is we have a combination of products and offerings that work great for streaming corporate communications. So today what we're going to talk about is we're going to talk about the video toolkit you need, what gear you need. We're going to talk about the details of the two products that we offer that we're using to stream corporate communications. First, we're going to walk through some of the common use cases and scenarios you might see. Then we're going to talk about the gear, and then we're going to go through the workflow end-to-end of how we get our signals from our cameras and our audio sources into the Roland VR50 mixer and switcher into Ustream Producer and Ustream Align. That's going to be our agenda for today.
Great. Well, thanks, Alden. And let's talk a little bit about some of the examples we can use for corporate communications. Maybe some of the things you can do is stream your meetings. A lot of times companies hold board meetings or weekly meetings. That's a great way of connecting to your audience. Maybe another example might be training. So you have a new product that you're launching or a new update, and you want to share that information and train your sales staff, train your customers on how to use the product. Maybe another example might be webinars like we're doing here today. You want to talk about new subjects, new products, that type of thing. You can host webinars. Maybe another example might be a CEO town hall where you bring in your CEO and you have a studio audience and they're asking questions. Maybe he's giving a direction, he or she is giving direction of where the company is going, what the company is doing, basically. It's providing a studio audience, basically. The last thing might be new product introductions. This shot looks very, very familiar, Alden. So it's a great way to introduce the products without having to go and visit every single one of your customers in person. You can do a product introduction so everybody has information about the new product.
So what's interesting about these examples is in three out of the five, so two of the five, the webinar and this product introduction, you know, it's just for the web. There's no audience in the room. But the other three, there's a pretty good crowd of people in the room. And so this is something that we're seeing. So for example, the CEO town hall, this was in our office here, and a lot of the company is based here in San Francisco. Mm-hmm. However, we have employees that work from home, or they might be in remote offices, or for example, you're based in Seattle, and Roland's headquarters is in LA. And so we're seeing this trend of a lot of employees are not necessarily located physically in the same place. Because of all the productivity tools we have, it's very easy to connect with people online. But one of the things you'll find, and this is why streaming and live streaming, corporate meetings and trainings and CEO town halls have become very popular, is that it's a way that you can connect those remote employees in the same way, engage them with the actual presentation in the same way that someone could be in the same room as them.
Absolutely. And last week, one of our owner's board of directors came to our office in Los Angeles, and we streamed his keynote address to the whole company so that the employees that were not there were able to watch that stream. And we also have two office locations, so we have a distribution center and a main office, and so they were able to stream it over to the distribution center and they were able to watch as well. So it's a great way of connecting employees to your communications. So let's talk a little bit about what are the video toolkit essentials for streaming corporate communications. We believe that really you need to have at least two cameras so you can provide a different point of view. Get some sort of integrated audio and video mixer switcher, or a video mixer and audio mixer. A laptop for doing your graphics or streaming. Maybe a tablet like I have here for playing video content. Or you get a video player. A couple microphones. You want to microphone your talent. You can use handheld, you can use wireless microphones. Then you're going to need some sort of lighting. We have a couple of lighting pieces here in this room, as well as encoding streaming services to get your content out to your audience. And then, as we mentioned, there's a lot of corporate events where you have a studio audience. So having some sort of screen, as well as depending on the size, you might need a PA system. So you can actually hear the speaker in the room. So we believe those are essentially the video toolkit that you need to stream corporate communications. So Alden, let's talk a little bit about what we're using here for our stream.
Sure, yeah. So we get this question a lot, and a lot of times people go, well, hey, I don't know exactly how to make it look great, but what you're doing looks okay, so what are you guys using? So we're gonna tell you about the different pieces of gear that we're using here. And one thing I'll stress is it's not necessarily about, you don't have to use the exact makes and models that we have here, but it's about finding what works for your workflow. And also a lot of times, you know, we didn't necessarily, I'll tell you, you know, we made some good choices and we made some bad choices in the different things we bought over the years. And so sometimes, you know, you buy one thing, you realize it's not right and you need to go out and buy something else. That's okay. So we'll try to give you some recommendations though of things that we're using here that we like and why they work for us. And you need to think about it yourself, and we'll talk in more detail about, you know, the reason why, for example, the products we're showing today, like Roland's VR50 and using something like Ustream, can be good choices as part of that toolkit, as part of the whole workflow, because they provide a lot of flexibility and they provide an ease of use that's very important when you have a lot of different pieces you need to set up. So first, let's start with cameras. So a lot of times people get very focused on cameras and they go, what kind of camera do I need to stream? What kind of camera? The truth is you can use almost any camera that's out there to stream. It's just some might be better choices than others. So there's two that we're using in the studio today. One is a Canon C100, and this is more like it's close to a Canon 5D DSLR, but it's designed more for video. And so what's nice about it is you can get a really pretty nice look out of it. You can do interchangeable lenses and that type of thing. It's a little bit more expensive than a typical corporate, maybe video production camera. So another camera we're using here is the Panasonic HPX. These are a little bit older, so they're discontinued now, but there's some equivalent models in the market. But one example with these two is that one of them has an HDMI output, the other has an SDI output, and Rob will show you in a little bit how using something like the Roland VR50, you can actually mix and match different camera sources, because that's something you might run into the real world, just like we have here. We have a bunch of different cameras and none of them are matched, which can be somewhat inconvenient, but with the right pieces in between, you can pull it together and make it work together.
Absolutely.
We're using the Roland VR50 here, and Rob's going to go through that in detail. We're using a couple MacBook Pros. One is a Source. It's running the slides, and the other is what we're using to run Ustream Producer and actually stream out our final product. We're using an iPad to play back videos, which is a cool way to do it, and it's a very portable way to have a video playback deck right in your hand. You can just touch it to start your videos. We're using two Sennheiser wireless lav mics. These are a great investment. Highly recommend you think very carefully about audio, because something like a wireless lav is great. It frees up your hands, you can talk, and also you don't have to worry so much about mic technique, because one thing that I found, you know, you work with a lot of different presenters, you have a mic like this, and maybe if you're a pro like Rob, you'll know to talk into it like this, but you have some people that will kind of do this, and the next person does one of this because they saw their favorite performer talking into it like that. And so I really like wireless lav mics, because you get a nice, clean, consistent sound. You don't have to worry about the presenter knowing how to hold a microphone or doing something incorrect with it that'll hurt the sound quality. And then finally, for lighting, lighting is something that can make a very, very big difference in the quality of how good your video image looks, even more so than the camera sometimes. So we're using lights here called KinoFlows, and a lot of people like to use these, and they're fluorescent-based lights. What I recommend is look at either fluorescent or LED-based lights. There's other types of lights, but the problem, the thing that's nice about fluorescents or LEDs is that the bulbs are cheap, they last forever, they don't get hot, and they use normal power. So the more sophisticated type of lighting that they'll use on like an actual Hollywood film, you can get more specific looks with it, but the thing is that there's a lot of complexity that comes with it and a lot of potential pitfalls. And so for typical kind of basic corporate video production, something like KinoFlows, a fluorescent kit, or something like an LED-based light are great choices, and they'll make a world of difference. Seriously, if you're going to go out and spend $1,000, you're better off spending $1,000 on lighting than spending $1,000 buying a $3,000 camera versus a $2,000 one, because you'll see a big step up in the difference of using no lighting versus using just a little bit of lighting.
Absolutely. And really the last thing you really need is some sort of content delivery network, and we believe the number one would be using Ustream Producer to get your content out to your audience securely as well. So
we talked about all the different pieces, so I think what we'll do next is Rob's going to talk specifically about the Roland VR50 and how we're bringing in these different signals. So you have cameras, you have audio, you got to bring them together, and you got to put them together into a coherent presentation, because you know you got to switch between them. Maybe you want to do picture in picture. You want to get your audio levels right, because that stuff is really important to make sure that the final presentation, you know, what you want is you don't want to draw any attention to the presentation, right? You want it to just be something that people can see everything clearly, they can hear everything clearly. And then after you go through the VR50, we'll talk about how you use Ustream Producer and Ustream Align to present that out. And I didn't mention earlier, so I'll mention now, we will be taking your questions. What we're going to do is we're going to go through the presentation and we'll answer all your questions at the end. And so please ask your questions in the social stream. That's the interactive module you see right to the right of the video player. And we'd love to answer your questions about, you know, if you're looking for recommendations about what the right approach is, what the right gear is, if you have some specific questions about Roland's products or Ustream products, we'd be happy to answer them for you. So please ask your questions. And after we show you the workflow here, we'll jump into your questions as well. So let's go into the workflow with the VR50.
Perfect. And I'm going to actually go to the slides, because really what I want to show is how do you get these pieces and components into an AV switcher. And so I'm going to show you the back of the Roland VR50. So basically, here's the video mixer input. So we have four SDI inputs. As we mentioned, we have an SDI camera here, and it has four HDMI inputs as well. So we have an HDMI camera. So nice to be able to mix camera sources, video sources, either SDI or HDMI. We also have two RGB component for analog HD signals or computer signals that you want to send directly into the switcher, as well as composite. So composite, you can actually plug in standard definition resolution video sources. And because the VR50 has scaling on the input, I can scale that standard definition resolution signal all the way up to 1080p or whatever resolution that I'm outputting. Very nice to mix and match video resolution sources. Let's talk a little bit about the outputs. So there are two SDI outputs, two HDMI outputs, plus a multi-view output, as well as two RGB component outputs. And again, these are all active and live. One can be a program, the other can be an aux, which is great if you want to have, like, you want to set up a confidence monitor or a monitor in your room or a screen in your room. So that's really, really great.
And this is an important functionality. This is one of the reasons that, you know, we started using the VR50 here for our own internal presentations. And one of the reasons why we really got sold on it was one of the biggest challenges I always had was that you had a presenter that wanted to do some slides, and you needed those slides to go to your web stream, but you also needed those slides to go to your screen in the room. And if you've ever had to do this kind of setup, one of the problems that you run into is that usually when you have something like an output on one side and an input on the other, they need to match very carefully in their resolutions. And so by putting the VR50 as sort of this intermediary step, what you're able to do is you're able to pull in basically anything and then send it out in the right format. So if you want to send out just a stream or just a feed of, say, your slides on an HDMI cable, you can do that, and it can show up nicely on your TV or projector, which is a really nice benefit that you can pull in those slides, you can mix them in as a source for your web stream, and you can switch between that and your cameras and put titles over or whatever, yep. But you can also send it out to a screen.
And that's actually how we have it set up here in the studio, is my slides here are sending an aux out to this monitor behind us. So it's a great way of bringing in your studio audience to what you're doing with the slides in your presentation.
And the same way with the audio too, you can also use, which you're about to talk to about now, mm-hmm. You can also use it as a mixer for your PA and a mixer for your web stream, all in the same thing, because on the output side, you're separating those outputs, so I can feed a different master level to my web stream than to my in-house.
Exactly. Yeah. And so, as you just mentioned, there's physical audio inputs on there, so you can take your wireless microphones, your handheld microphones. You can also bring in audio levels from maybe another mixer or something like that, or maybe an iPod you want to play as background music. You also have audio that can come from your video sources as well. So audio that's embedded into the HDMI signal or even the SDI signal, you can then mix that into your whole entire production, which is really great for live production. So let's talk about the outputs. There's two just XLR outputs plus RCA outputs. Plus you have output from the embedded audio into your video signals as well. So SDI and HDMI, because those are digital signals. Lastly, let's just talk a little bit about the key thing about the VR50 HD, and that has a USB 3.0, 2.0 port on the back. And what it does is it takes my audio and video that I've produced and it sends it out uncompressed through that port, and I can plug it in directly into my computer, directly into Ustream Producer.
So you're going to show a little bit about how you actually operate the VR50, right?
So exactly. So let's talk a little bit about the VR50 and how you set some things up. So the first thing I'm going to show is actually how you set up the audio. So I have a handheld microphone here, and I go into my setup window, and now you can see I'm talking into this microphone, and I can adjust my gain, and notice how it's now peaking, so I can bring that down. I have 48 volt phantom power for microphones that require that, high pass filter, delays, aux delay, there's EQ, there's gates, there's compressors, so every single one of my first four channels have these effects built into it. So now that I've set my audio levels, I can just put my microphone down. Let's talk a little bit about how I set up my audio from a video source. So I have my iPad here, and it's playing a video, and I have it on source 4. And let me exit out of here. And I can play that video content directly through there. And then if I go into my setup for this, I can actually choose either line level or microphone level. So I can go in there and choose video. Line level or video level. So I can just bring the volume up, and now you can see that I have audio coming through there. So that's how I set up my audio sources. All right, so let's talk a little bit about the video workflow. So I go into my input assign button, and that allows me to set up what physical input I'm connecting my video source to. So as you can see, we have a 1080i signal on input 1, a 1080p signal on input 2, my computer coming on input 3, all different video resolutions. As you can see, it seamlessly mixes and matches those video resolutions and outputs it as one source. So I just simply tap on that. That's how you set up the video input sources. As I mentioned, there's scaling on the input and output, so let's go to video source 1, which is my camera. I have my camera here in the background. You can see I can zoom up or zoom down, and I can also change the horizontal size, horizontal and vertical positions. So full scaling, you can do letterbox, crop, dot by dot, or manual scaling on every single one of the inputs. So let's talk a little bit about the composition effects. So if I wanted to, I could actually bring my presentation up by just hitting my picture-in-picture button. So that's my computer presentation coming up. Or if I wanted to, I can maybe switch my computer presentation and then bring up a little picture of me down the bottom window. So that's how quickly and easily you can do picture-in-picture, which is really, really key for doing corporate presentations. You can actually also install still images. So I've got a USB flash key here, and if I hit my load still, I can load in a logo, that type of thing, and then it stores it into the still memory, and then all I have to do is hit my still key button. And as you can see, I have my Roland logo. It's on a black background. I just use the little dial here, and I can key out the black. So that's how I do keying and picture-picture and compositing. I can also do transition as well. I have white patterns. Right now, I'm doing a mix between my video sources. If I wanted to, I can do straight cuts between my camera sources, that type of thing. Or I can do a white pattern if I wanted to. So very, very quickly and easily, I've got my transition effects, my composition effects. The other thing I want to show is it's got a built-in multi-viewer, so you can see your sources, you can see what your composition looks like and where those are. You can also tap on the video sources to actually switch. So really, really intuitive, easy to use. That's really the workflow of this. The last thing that I really want to talk about is how do I get my audio and video signal out. As I mentioned, it's a USB 3.0 connection. I have that connected to Alden's computer here. I'm sending out a 720p signal at 59.94. And so it's taking my audio and video and combining that two together and sending it directly to the computer. So now I'm going to turn it over to Alden, who's really going to talk about how do I get my content delivered to my audience, as well as how do I secure that content to the audience.
Yeah, so the first thing we're going to look at here, Rob, is we're going to look at our Ustream Producer software. And Ustream Producer is available for Mac and for Windows. Here we're running it on a Mac laptop. And one of the things that we got really excited about with the Roland VR50 is, so Ustream Producer, you can run it on a computer and you can install capture cards, or you can use, for example, we sometimes use a capture device, which brings it in over USB or Thunderbolt. But you know, when you look at like what the VR50 offers, it's not like a single camera capturing in. we have a multitude of inputs and outputs.
Absolutely.
And that's what you kind of need to really do. We talk about video toolkit essentials for streaming corporate communications. You know, it's not that common that you have a situation where you go, well, we can really get by with just a single camera and a single audio source.
Right.
And it's not because you need all your productions to be these amazing multi-camera things with crazy lighting, but what it is that it's just quite common that you'll have at least one presenter, you have at least one PowerPoint source,
yep.
You might have two presenters, and then you'll have this situation where, well, you have a PA, and you have a you have a monitor that the in-person audience needs to see. So very quickly, your production, and depending on what scale you're operating on, you may need to be the person that does both the in-house AV and the web stream. And so very quickly, you have demands that go beyond just single camera and single audio source, even on a very simple production.
Yeah.
And so what we like a lot about the VR50, especially putting this, you know, in a workflow with Ustream Producer, is that you look at that back panel of the VR50. So if we can go to that shot again, you know, and here we're highlighting this USB output, which is what we eventually pull in a producer. But you have all these inputs and outputs, so you can really work with whatever gear is available. And if you're doing it for an installed, you know, setup, for example, at a company like ours, it's great. But also if you want to use it for some portable production, it's great too, because you have a lot of flexibility, mm-hmm. and you can show up, and even if people throw different things at you, you can accommodate them.
Exactly.
And the other thing we like is it's a small footprint. So it's not like, you know, here, for example, in our office, we need to set up a very small tech table on the side of where we do our meeting. And so we can't have a big control room with lots of gear. So what we have is we have a laptop and we have this VR50. Which is a very small footprint, and yep. we're able to do everything there, including power our PA, including power our monitors. And so it's a great combination we see.
Yeah, you really need to simplify your workflow. And I think that that's one of the things that going with an integrated audio and video mixer like this and using Ustream Producer together simply by connecting the USB cables, you really eliminate a lot of cables and equipment that you need to set up otherwise. And simplifying your workflow allows you to do more frequency of these type of webinars and these type of meetings. So
that's one thing that, you know, we're looking for. And so I think it ties in nicely. And we're going to show a video in a little bit, but it features, so we created a couple case study videos. You know, you created one about us using the VR50, we created one about you guys using Ustream Align, and one of the things our CEO mentioned in one of the videos, he said, you know, you guys have a simplicity and ease of use. You made something that was complicated, made it easy, and that's what we've done with Ustream as well. You know,
yeah.
It could be a very complicated thing to be able to stream live to the web and deliver that to a lot of people all at
sure.
once. We've made it pretty easy, so I'll show you how we've made it easy here. So you look at Ustream Producer, here's the main interface, and one of the nice things about the VR50 is that it shows up as a class-compliant USB device, which what that means is that I literally didn't have to install any drivers or anything. I just plug it into my USB port, and it shows up as a source, just like my webcam shows up. So I already added it here, but all you need to do is just do add VR50 audio video shot, and it shows up. And now I can stream this live. So what I do is we're going to show next our Ustream Align product. And our Ustream Align product is specifically designed for secure internal corporate communications. What it is you set up your employees to log in either verifying their email address that they work at your domain, or you can set it up with Google Apps if you're using Google Apps for your domain, or we work with different directory systems such as Active Directory or OneLogin or Okta through the SAML SSO standard. So we're going to show you how you can stream this, and then you can have a secure end-to-end workflow, and it's easy for your employees to access it, to watch it. So we'll stream it here live. And I'm streaming to one of my Ustream Align channels. I can also record it locally here, so that way, if for some reason I want to save a copy to do something with it later, it's right now recording on my hard drive, it's recording in the cloud on Ustream servers, and we're streaming it live. So let's go take a look at that. So here's my Ustream Align dashboard, and I have different channels for my different departments. So we talked about the different workflows or use cases earlier. You might want to do sales trainings. You might want to do a CEO town hall. So we have different channels for each of those. Here we have our office briefing channel, which is where we're streaming live. So this is the signal coming from our VR50 through Ustream Producer, and we're streaming it live to the web right now. And this experience is available on desktop. It's available on iOS, on Android. And let's look at how does it look with the so you give me black right now, but you got something, we got some video playback here. So here's our slides, and let's take a look at, maybe we can do a picture-in-picture with, you know, there's me talking, maybe there's the slides overlaid on the top there, and we could also do the reverse. This is a very common look that a lot of people want to do, which is, there we go, which is we want to see the slides, and then we want to see the presenter down in the bottom right-hand corner. This is a really common one that people want to do for corporate communications because they want to be able to feature the content but then show, you know, a presenter there. So the VR50 allows you to kind of create these different looks, and then you can stream those to Ustream. So we'll take a look at the other features inside the Ustream Align dashboard. And one thing that we get a lot, people ask us, well, okay, you can stream live. Can you also record? Yes, you can. So we'll take a look here. Here's some of the videos that we created through our the rehearsals we were doing for this. And you can take a look at any of these videos here. And once you have your videos in your dashboard, you can edit them, you can download them, you can share them individually. So for example, let's say we want to take just this clip, we want to share this, we can go to our embed menu here, and now we have this as its own file. And so for example, if we wanted to put this on a company intranet page or something like that, we can share it in different places. You saw the hosted viewing experience for Ustream Align, but this is also a way you can share individual videos. You have different options, you can make them auto-playing or not. And all you have to do is just grab this quick embed code, and then you can feature it on maybe your company wiki or intranet or something like that. And then the final feature of Ustream Align, which is something that we added that was really specific for corporate communications, was we added this individual viewer tracking. So one kind of funny thing
that we got... Big Brother is watching.
Yeah, well, you know, people say it's Big Brother, but, you know, one of the genuine concerns that we have is people said, well, look, if I do a training or a meeting, I can see who's in the room.
Yeah.
But, you know, if I don't really know if someone's watching online, and it's not enough to just say, oh, well, seven people viewed it, because who are those seven, and how do I know it wasn't just someone opening up seven browser windows or something. So we added this tracking feature, and this has been a really interesting part of it, so that you can get that same kind of thing. So if we want to see, okay, we did this presentation on December 8th, and who are the people that watched it, we can see the actual names, and we can see, so for example, this was a live stream. It probably started early. There was nothing going on, and then this was top of the hour when it started. So now we had nine people watch this segment, and it actually grew over time, which is great.
Right.
It shows that people are staying engaged. And then you can go in and you can watch on individual viewers. You can say, okay, I want to know, you know, how much did this particular person watch? And so, you know, we see some videos they didn't watch that much, other ones they watched all of. And that's important because that way, and you can download the data, so if you want to verify, for example, that we had a certain attendance at a meeting, or that, you know, we had a series of training videos and you had to watch all of them, you can actually see verification whether or not people are watching and staying engaged with the content.
I think this is a great feature, especially if you have some sort of mandated training that you want to provide your employees. And maybe as an HR person, you want to see, okay, tick it off the list. They went through this training module or that type of thing. Or, you're just able to see what your audience is and see which employees were able to watch your production. So.
And the other part of it, which is, you know, and it'll be a good segue into our question segment, which we're going to do in just a minute here, is that you also have this chat capability. So just like now, you're able to watch us, you're able to ask us questions, and we're able to interact. You're able to do the same thing with your corporate communications. And so, for example, if you want to do something where you have one of your leadership talk and employees can ask questions, you can offer that. And we even have different moderation modes and everything. So if you don't want everyone to see every question, you can choose that. So that's what we've built in Ustream Align. And it's been a very popular product to allow people to share their CEO town halls, their trainings, their meetings, do product demos and webinars like we were talking about earlier.
Yeah.
And we wanted to show this workflow today to show how, you know, there's a great product in this Roland VR50 to sort of give you something that's compact, it has a simple workflow, and it helps to take some of that mystery out of how do I pull this all together and how can I stream it in an efficient way without, you know, bringing in a truckload of gear and a million rolling cases and 10 guys. How can I do it with, you know, maybe one person and a very small footprint? And I think that's what we're able to accomplish with this.
One of the number one questions we get asked is, you know, okay, the hardware is cool and it does a lot, but what streaming service do you recommend? And it's great to be able to talk with you know, a partner like Ustream and say, hey, you plug in the USB out and you plug it into Producer and you're ready to stream. So having a switcher that has the tactile controls, has the ability to do multi-formats, and to be able to send that all together through a USB output that is uncompressed all the way up to 1080p to get beautiful picture quality, as you can see on our stream, is great to be able to say, hey, just plug it into Producer and it works well.
Yeah. So we said we're going to talk about Video Toolkit Essentials. We have a couple other things we'd like to highlight as essentials, and one is, we'd say, you know, you want to think about bringing a lot of different cables and making sure that you don't skimp on cables because you always need something. We have one of the biggest essentials of video production, which do we have? Oh, can we grab this here?
Yeah, let's this show is, that.
This is
one of our
This
essentials.
Is your Video Toolkit Essential. This is called gaff tape. And we're having fun with it, but I can't stress enough, seriously, this is a Video Toolkit Essential, because if you remember to tape down your things, it'll prevent people from tripping on them. If you tape down connections, it'll prevent them from falling out in the middle of a production and having a key source get disconnected. So this is one Video Toolkit Essential.
Yeah.
Rob has a literal toolkit he brought with him.
I brought lots of stuff. But
so we're going to show a couple other things, which we may be getting out of Essential now and getting into some more, you know, specific use cases, but there's always a solution for what you need to do. So one of the problems, I'll set this one up for you. One of the problems you run into is that SDI cameras are great because you can do great long cable runs with them. The problem is SDI cameras are expensive and you don't always have SDI inputs and outputs. So this is a way you can do HDMI, which are, you have a lot more options for cameras, and you're able to convert that. So what is this here?
These are HD base D converters. So what it allows you to do is take an HDMI in from your camera source, and let's say, for example, you have your HDMI camera and it's sitting 100 feet away from your switcher because you're in a larger room. Well, you're not going to get an HDMI cable to go 100 feet, so you're going to need to do some sort of transfer. So what this does is take HDMI in, and it takes a Cat6 cable, and you can then plug in the Cat6 cable here on the output, and then the receiver you plug in the other end, and then HDMI out into your switcher. And you can go up to 328 feet with your Cat6 cable. And it's called HD Base T, and these are really, really a simple pair of essential tools for streaming corporate communications. The other thing that I wanted to show is you don't necessarily have to go with kind of a larger type switcher. You can also go to something that's a little bit more compact. This is our brand new V1HD. It's going to be shipping and available next week. It's an HDMI switcher, but you can switch all the way up to 1080p. You've got four different inputs, and you can bring external audio inputs, and then there's a mic audio input as well. So really, really simple. You don't need to go super high end. You can just use this and maybe with a small HDMI camera, and you can do some of the corporate communication.
And, that has the same USB streaming output, or
it,
no?
It doesn't, but okay. You can get a little converter box that takes HDMI out because yep. It combines the audio and video together. USB 3 directly yep. into Ustream Producer. Real sure. simple, $300 solution for that.
So we're going to go to some questions in a minute. So what we'll do first is we're going to play, we have two video clips. One is Roland made a video about us at Ustream using the VR50, and you can get some shots of our setup and how we're using it, and watch a couple interviews of people here that were using it. And then we also have a video where we went to the Roland Studios, and the Roland Studios we're a bit jealous. They're a bit more impressive than ours. And you guys have a bunch of cool musicians and stuff visiting you. So, we went to the Roland Studios, and we talked with some of your people about how you're using Ustream Align as well. So, yep. So we'll play those clips, and then we'll come back and we'll answer your questions.
Ustream, like many companies, has grown very rapidly on a global basis. As you would expect, when you have multiple offices, it can be a challenge to have positive alignment, alignment around your vision, alignment around goals. But through live streaming, through video, you can get that connection between teams that are spread out globally and all around the world. One of the biggest benefits of the VR50 that I'm hearing from our production team is the fact that you can have multiple inputs into the switcher.
VR50 for us is a perfect complement because it has that hardware interface to do audio, to do video switching, and it has all the inputs and outputs and resolution matching that you need to be able to work nicely with a software-based encoder. You could feed your aux output to your house projection screen. You can take your program output and send that to a recording.
The VR50 allows you to get audio and video signals out through the USB 3.0 in the back of the device. That allows you to get a really beautiful 1080p signal out from the VR50 into Ustream Producer or whatever encoding software you're actually using.
The features have been kind of perfect. It allows you to do the type of advanced production you want to do, but it's also very easy to understand and wrap your head around and get started with.
The VR50 is actually a very powerful product that works incredibly well with the Ustream and our products, Ustream Align and Ustream Demand. And that simplicity and that easy use of the combination of those two products allows us to do weekly meetings. We can do these daily if we wanted to because it's so easy to set up. And if you even have something last minute and you want to get it out to your customers very rapidly or get out to your employees very rapidly, this combination of the setup is very powerful.
Roland is the world's largest maker of electronic musical instruments in the world.
40 years doing some of the world's best music instruments, but most people don't know that about 25 years ago we started creating video products.
We try to meet a couple times a year surrounding our trade shows, but that was just not enough. We've tried the teleconference, and that comes with its own set of issues.
Security is definitely important for us when we're having our internal meetings. We're disseminating information that we don't want to get into the hands of our competitors, but also even we're giving maybe sales tactics that clearly we don't want to give away or have be shared.
Using Ustream, we have full security and confidence that we can have this kind of communication and keep it private.
And then, of course, the interactive chat is one of the best things. We're able to answer questions right away and have that dialogue with people and answer their questions as they're coming up. And in some cases, even prompt the presenter, oh, by the way, could you answer this or could you answer that? Gives us that real-time feedback and sometimes that real-time production. That's been fantastic.
It helps us relay our message a lot better. And the fact that we can save it and they can go back to it over and over and over again, it makes the retention rate of everything we're doing so much higher.
It's high quality, looks great wherever, and we've had great comments from everyone. It's been great.
All right, hope you enjoyed the videos, taking a look at Roland Studios and taking a look at Ustream's office, and we talked about how we use our products in a real world situation. We're going to go to your questions now, and lots of people asking great questions. If you still have some more questions to ask, you can ask those in the social stream chat module, which is the right of the video player. So I'll pose one to you first, Rob. So Okay. Someone asks, so what would you say is the key difference between the Roland product and other products that might be out there on the market that might do similar functions?
Sure, we touched on that a little bit, and really some of the key components is the ability to take multiple formats in. A lot of the other production switchers that you see on the market, you have to select a single format. And then so what you're doing is say like you select 1080p, but you have a 1080i source, now you need to convert that, or actually a 720p source, you need to now convert that to a 1080 signal. So the ability to actually plug in multiple video sources, mix and match those, and output at one resolution. I think some of the other key things is what we had touched on earlier, the ability to not only stream with it, but to do a live production with it. Zero, very, very low latency on it, so you can actually, you don't have lag that goes from your production switcher to the screen in your room, like some of the other production switchers are just designed for doing streaming. So I think those are some of the key features, and then also having the ability of a full 12-channel audio mixer built in there with effects, so you can really get a sweet audio mix in there.
Yeah, I was going to highlight that last one, actually, if you didn't pick up on it, because that's one of the things that struck me about it, because if you, I came from an audio background, and so did Roland, actually. Roland was originally an audio company, and one thing you find with a lot of video products is that it's not, you may have sort of the ability to mix the audio channels and software, but audio tends to be a thing you have to really be able to get hands-on with the faders, and you know, if someone starts coughing into a mic, you want to be able to duck that down or mute it really quickly, or you need to be kind of waiting for the moment when the person arrives on stage, because if you have their mic on when they're backstage, you might catch them saying something bad, but if you don't have it on when they say their first word, that looks terrible as well.
Right.
So having sort of that full hardware, tactile audio mixing interface interface is, I think it's a big differentiator from this and some of the other similar products I've seen out there. Because when I've used some other video switching products, you know, what you end up having to do is you end up having a separate audio mixer that you run in front of it.
Exactly.
So there's definitely an advantage there. So a couple questions and comments as well here. So someone asked about, would streaming and recording on the computer slow down anything? So that was, I think, in relation to using Ustream Producer. And so if you record at the same resolution as you stream at, it's only doing one encode, and it's just writing a file and then streaming it, so it doesn't slow it down too much. And someone else responded to that, by the way, saying that if you have about an i5 or better processor, you should be in pretty good shape. And I'd say that's a decent benchmark. You need to have a capable computer. You don't want to find, you know, like the oldest, worst, slowest computer that you have and try to do something like video encoding on it. That's pushing a little bit too much. But the other advantage with using something like the VR50 in front of, say, a laptop running Ustream Producer is that if I'm only taking one signal from the VR50 and I'm just streaming from here, I'm not trying to play back videos from here and switch between 10 different sources. And so it also is a little bit less taxing on the computer, which is nice. So that works out pretty well. Then another question here. Well, we got a feature request for you, which, you know, I won't put you on the spot too much, but just something to think about for future.
Okay.
Someone said they love Tally Light capability. So that's something to think about. If you're not familiar with Tally Lights, that's the little light that lets you know which camera's on, so you know which one to look into. We don't even have that here, so we have a complicated system of hand signals and guessing. But Tally Lights could be useful, so that's something. Someone else said inputs that permit DSLR usage. I don't think there's any particular input that you would need, but I'll make a quick comment about DSLRs because we get the comment a lot. So we're using a Canon C100 here, which Canon specifically made the C100 because the Canon 5D, very popular DSLR camera, was getting super popular for people making sort of, you know, lower budget feature films or documentaries. And the Canon C100, they specifically made as a more video focus of that. So you get all the advantages of sort of the picture quality of DSLR, but you get a couple key things. One is you get real audio inputs, and you could actually record audio with your video because you couldn't really do that with 5D. The second thing you get is you actually get real-time clean output, so you can pull out a video signal. So the biggest problem I see with DSLR cameras, a lot of them, you won't get a clean output. So basically, when you put the output of the camera to your Roland, what you'll see is a bunch of status overlays and a battery indicator and all that. So one thing you want to be careful when you pick a camera is make sure it can do a clean output. Whether it's DSLR or any other kind of camera, make sure it can do a clean output.
I think one of the questions maybe the person's really getting to is DSLR cameras typically have a different frame rate, and so they're probably, their experiences in plugging DSLR cameras into other switchers is they don't work. Mm-hmm. And the cool thing about it is the VR50, because it is multi-format, it not only will accept a 1080p signal or a 1080i signal, but it'll also accept the different frame rates as well. So it makes it easy to mix and match. Your video sources and DSLRs are known for having unusual frame rates. So,
Someone else said, are you able to do a video as an output stream to the Roland VR50? Are you familiar with that? A Teradek video is that? Okay.
Yeah. You can basically just take, you know, if you get the video with SDI in, you take the SDI signal directly into video or HDMI out into the video mini.
Okay. Someone else said, where can they find it? Where can they buy it? They couldn't, you know. So is there a place where you can buy it if you want
to? Our website, you can go to our website, which is proav.roland.com, and we actually have a where to buy button. You can find that on there and type in where you're at, and it'll send you to a local reseller.
All right, and final question I think is for me. Someone said, can you talk about the VOD and on-demand viewing workflow? So if we can look at my screen real quick here, this is the video library, and you can automatically record all of your live streams. And then on the viewing experience, you can watch them back. So for example, here's a video clip from our rehearsal yesterday, and you're able to access a video gallery as a viewer as well. So you can do everything you can do live, basically with VOD. It's just a little bit time delayed. It's not real time. So I think that's about it for our questions for today. We are going to show both of our contact information. So here's an image on the screen. Hopefully you can see it now. And we'll keep it up a little bit at the end. Hopefully we can do that so people can write it down or anything if they need to. Any final tips? What's your parting advice for our audience in terms of, you know, what's the essentials for corporate communications, whether it's a piece of gear or, you know, I gave my gaff tape tip earlier. I stole that one.
You stole that one.
What would you say is the, you know, really essential?
Well, besides all the gear, which is great to have, if you have the video toolkit essentials, I think that's really, really important for streaming your corporate communications. But I think the number one thing in my experience is planning and practicing. You know, everybody says, well, you know, you're industry experts, you make it look easy, that type of thing. But we didn't get there just by making it happen, just by chance. You know, it takes a lot of practice. It takes a lot of preparation. So I would encourage everybody to practice and plan, and so that your live webinars go very, very smoothly.
And you know, we can share our experience from what we set up in the last 2 days here. I mean, it's, you never know. Some things you plug them in and they work. Some things you plug them in and they don't work. Some things they don't work and you realize it's not plugged in. So you should always check that one as well. That's my tip of the day. And so our contact information is here. Please get in touch with us. We'd love to talk to you afterwards if you have additional questions. Thanks a lot for watching today. This has been Video Toolkit Essentials for Streaming Corporate Communications.
Thank you.